What is going on, Star Wars fans? You are in luck today, and it is going to be a good day for you because it looks like the KOTOR, the Knights of the Old Republic remake, is officially back from the dead. It looks like Embracer has approved a new developer working on the title, and we're going to see this game release after all. Let's get into it. Before we do, I'm Little Bobby from 5-9 Gaming Direct. Make sure that you hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell if you enjoy the content here. Leave us a like and comment as well. It really helps us out with the YouTube algorithm. So it looks like Bloomberg.com has a new article from Jason Schreier talking about the Star Wars KOTOR Knights of the Old Republic remake and it having a new developer. The project was originally helmed by Texas-based Aspyr Media. And their studio usually does a lot of PC ports and things like that. And they've done really great work in the past, but this was going to be their first big scale project. But we found out last month that the remake had been shelved, at least temporarily, because Embracer had seen some demo footage and things that Aspyr had put together, and they were not thrilled. That led to two of the directors, the art director, I believe, and the creative director, immediately being let go and the work being shelved for the time being. But it looks like Embracer has selected Saber Studios officially to revive this project and make sure that it actually gets out to gamers. So we're going to go through the article that Jason Schreier put out earlier today, and we're going to talk about the points and what they could mean for this remake moving forward. So after a quick introduction, basically saying what we've already pointed out, that the project has changed hands, Schreier goes on to write that the transition shuts down any lingering hope within Aspyr that it may be able to continue leading the project. Bosses at the studio, which had been developing the remake for more than 2 years, told staff last month that the game was on pause as the company tried to figure out what to do next, Bloomberg reported. The message left a possibility that Aspyr could one day claim the leadership role, but rumors quickly swirled among employees that Saber was taking over. So this is something that we pointed out not too long ago. There were these rumors going around that maybe Embracer had decided to put Saber in charge, and we talked about that in our Embracer group video that just came out, I believe, a day or two ago. Feel free to check that video out. It'll be pinned in the top right corner. But it looks to be clear that Embracer was not happy with the work that Aspyr was doing. They let the heads of the project go that were working for Aspyr, and they transferred over the entirety of the project to Saber Interactive, which I think is going to be pretty cool because it means that the game isn't going to necessarily be gone like we were initially thinking. But later on in the article, Schreier goes on to say, Embracer said it is not expecting any material delays due to the transition. There is something a little worrisome about that, in my opinion, because I've worked in game dev, I've seen like the game dev behind the scenes, and if you have people who don't know what's happening on a project or aren't fully in the loop, which Saber may not be, that could lead to ideas not really being fleshed out in the way they were initially intended, or systems in the game not really working out how they're supposed to. One of the saving graces, though, is that Saber has been on the project at least partially since the beginning. So there are some people at Saber who know what's going on with the project. Hopefully they can bring the rest of the teams up to speed and make sure that the remake is really up at that high quality that people would expect from a Knights of the Old Republic remake. One thing is for certain, though, we're not going to get this game anytime soon. Schreier even in the article says that the game was revealed at a PlayStation event last year, but does not have a public release date and will likely take at least 2 more years to finish, people familiar with the development said. So in this game, we can hopefully get a good KOTOR remake. I know my brother, I heard him scream yes, like he was Thor from Thor Ragnarok. So I know he's gonna be excited, but what do you guys think? Are you guys excited that the KOTOR remake really quickly seems to have recovered and is not gonna be lost in development limbo like a lot of other games have been for years and years and years? I know I personally am. I'm looking forward to getting like totally updated gameplay and systems and stuff like that. And I'm hoping that this game is really gonna deliver when it does eventually come out, probably in 2024, 2025. Let us know down in the comments, guys. Are you excited for KOTOR remake? Are you happy that the developer changed since it seems that Aspyr didn't live up to Embracer Group's expectations? Let us know anything and everything what you think down in the comments below. And remember, leave a like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell if you want to see more. Thanks again so much for watching 5-9 Gaming Direct. I'm Little Bobby, and I hope you have a great day.